the chapel at Arles. All right, Father, you may come closer.
I'm sorry to disturb you, my son. I know you like to pray alone.
You know who I am, Father?
Of course.
Is there something you want from me? Perhaps a favor or an advancement?
No.
Then what?
To be here with you. For this one moment, to touch you. To look in your eyes.
And what do you see?
Two eyes. A little cloudy with age. A sunset.
What else?
The death of thousands. The slavery of more. Terror and bloodshed.
Do you see that in my eyes?
Do you deny it?
Deny it? I'm proud of it. If I brought order out of chaos and slavery, blood, and death are a part of that order, so be it!
Those are words of the past. Time has passed you, my son.
And your time has come now? My son?
Yes, Father.
It's easy for you to stand there and judge for what I have done. When I marched, the dust of the road was in my nose. When I fought, the blood of the enemy was in my eyes. I sank in the mud of the Volga. I drowned two legions in the Vistula. Eagles, osprey, and vultures had a better view. But from the heights of it all, everything was very clear. Birds float on the wind. But by God, I blew my breath across a continent and shaped an empire with it.
My God, that was beautiful, Charles. Beautiful.
Did you like that?
I love it.
Oh, thank you so much. And you believe you can do better than I?
Yes, I do. I have to.
If you truly believe that, there's only one thing for you to do.
No, thank you. I brought my own.
Then you better use it. Or go and leave me in my prayer.
What do you pray for, Father?
I pray for strength, and that God give you the same. Hey!
Stop shaking when all the earth is still, when ancient ghosts are waking, so many steps need taking, so many plans need making, I think I will.
Your Majesty!
Pippin! Your Majesty!
Your Highness! King Pippin!
Morning glow, morning glow, starts to glimmer when you know winds of change are set to blow. Sweep this whole land through. Morning glow is long past due. Morning glow, fill the earth, come and shine for all your worth. We'll be present at the
Morning glow.
prepared to hear petitions.
Come forward. You will all be treated fairly. My invitation extends to high and low alike.
Sire, I am a poor woman.
Oh,
a peasant.
You may stand. You all may stand. No, that is completely unfair, but I will do something about it. I hereby decree that from now on, all peasants shall own the land they cultivate.
King Pippin, the just!
Sire, now that you've given our land to peasants, we loyal nobles have no source of income. Therefore, we can no longer pay taxes.
Then I hereby abolish taxes.
Oh. King Pippin! A generous!
You realize, sire, without taxes, you won't have enough money for an army.
Oh, that's okay. I don't need an army. That's it. No more taxes. No more army.
King Pippin, the peaceful.
Sire, it is my duty to inform you that we have been attacked by Hun the Infidel in the east.
Oh!
He's destroyed 3 villages.
Oh!
Raped hundreds of women.
Oh!
Tortured and murdered thousands of your royal subjects.
Oh!
Can he do that?
He has. However, he has agreed to withdraw under one condition.
Oh, well, that's very reasonable. I'm certainly willing to make some sort of small concession. What is the condition?
He demands your reproductive organs on a pike staff.
Well, then, I think it would be best if you go out and destroy the infidel.
But, sire, I have no more men to wage a campaign. I have no money to buy supplies. I have no army.
Good point. Excuse me, nobles. Remember that little decree you made a while ago about the land and the taxes?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, that's off.
You want me to pay taxes again? And raise an army?
Yes, that's right.
But sire, without land, I have neither money nor power over the peasants.
Good point. Peasants.
Yes, sire?
I hereby suspend the land reform.
Suspend land reform? You mean give it back?
Yes, that's right. Give it back.
I'm dying, sire.
Take that woman away and hang her!
Oh, no!
Well, okay, wait, stop. Stop. Just give me a minute to think, please.
Darling, you're a born ruler. You're doing a wonderful job. Nothing has changed since your father died. Now, about my allowance account.
We need an army!
No, denied!
King Pippin! Unpopular.
Everybody out of my courtroom! I need to pray.
Pray? What in the world would you pray for?
Strength.
Well, is there anything else you'd like?
Yes. I want my knife back.
You want it? You got it!
Thank you so much.
I'm sorry, Father.
Oh, that's okay, son. Just don't let it happen again.
Damn it! Nothing turns out the way I thought it would. I'm getting old. Very old, and I still haven't done anything with my life.
But you will. You will.
You will. You look frenzied, you look frazzled, pink as any cow, flushed and crushed and frazzle-dazzled. Try your lip, damp your scowl, now I can see you're in a rut. But in fact,
say. If you take it easy, trust a while. Don't look blue. Don't look back. You'll pull through in just a while. 'Cause you're on the right track. Keep those hopes aloft. Keep cool as custard. Trying hard, stepping soft. There's no trick to staying sensible despite each goal that's set. 'Cause each step's indispensable when you're on the right track. Yeah, babe.
Right track.
Trying art, the creative life, and what he discovered was...
You gotta be dead before you figure out if you're any good or not.
Then Pippin dedicated himself to the church. He sought God in the highways. He sought the man in the byways. And then he cornered God in this giant cathedral. And what he found out was...
The church isn't interested in saving souls. It's investing in real estate.
Maybe when things get dank, we'll feel their grip. Go, we stay. Tranquil spirits high, pulses low.
But what I've left behind looks trifling. What's ahead looks black. Am I doomed to spend my life lingering on?
Easy, baby! You're on the right track! Enter Catherine!
Okay, well, why don't we try it again?
Enter Catherine! A widow with a very large estate.
When I first saw Pippin, he was lying on the road like a discarded rag. I would have passed him by. Perhaps I should have passed him by. But there was something about his foot. Yes, it was the arch of his foot that caught my eye. What I did was merely an act of Christian charity. After all, I had no idea that this discarded rag would clean up so well. The man had obviously lost the will to live, so the first thing I had to do was to get him interested in something. Something that would restore his faith in life. Something like... me. Well, I'm sure there are many things you'd like to know about me, aren't there?
No.
Good. My name is Catherine. I'm a widow. I have a son, and I own this estate. I'm your average, ordinary kind of woman, competent and neat, making life a treat, others as nice, you meet often, I know, at least once or twice, every decade or so. I'm your everyday very kind of woman, practical as salt, modest to a fault, conservative with a budget, liberal with a meal, just your average ideal. My telling you this may seem sudden and it may not interest you much at all right now, but things change, things change. Still, I'll understand if I'm not your kind of woman. Anyone can make one terrible mistake.
I think he's really moved. and I'm here all alone. I can't do all this work by myself. Couldn't you please help me?
You're supposed to read the line naggingly.
But he touched my hand. They don't usually do that.
I don't care what he touches. Read it naggingly.
Pippin, this is such a large estate, and I'm here all alone. I can't do all of this work by myself. Couldn't you please help me?
All right. Fine. But just for a little while.
Well, Pippin was finally out of bed and working, and slowly he became a part of everything. A part of our everyday lives.
How often do we do this?
Every day.
Every day?
Uh-huh.
Fantastic. What are you looking at?
Nothing. Nothing.
I know that look. That's the look of a widow with a large estate to run, a boy to raise, and no one to sit at the head of the table.
Much enthusiasm for his work, but as time went on, he showed no enthusiasm at all.
So keep up the good work, boys. Did you say something?
No. Oh, Pippin, there is something. The roof on the chicken house has sprung a leak. If you could get to it tomorrow.
What?
Or the day after tomorrow.
Fix the roof of the chicken house? I used to be the emperor of the entire Holy Roman Empire. All right, so I screwed it up. Still. Patching the roof and pinching the hay. Not my idea of a perfect day when you're extraordinary. You gotta do extraordinary things. Now I'm not the type who loses sleep over the size of the compost heap. When you're extraordinary, you think about extraordinary things. That's the reason I'll never be the kind of man who dwells on how moths got into the tapestries or why the dungeon smells. Oh, it's hard to feel special. It's hard to feel big. Feeding a turtle and walking a pig. It's so secondary to someone who is very extraordinary like me. If the mow won't stop leaking and the dome won't stop shrinking and the griffin keeps losing his hair, if the west wing is rotting and our best line is clotting, well, I'm terribly sorry, but I don't care. I've gotta be someone who lives all of his life in superlatives. I'm extraordinary. I gotta do extraordinary things. The fact that I'm different is easy to see. So why doesn't anybody know it but me? I'm extraordinary. I gotta do extraordinary things. Every so often a man has a day he truly can call his. Well, here I am to seize my day. If someone would just tell me when the hell it is. Oh, give me my chance. Give me my wings. And don't make me think about everyday things. It's unnecessary for someone who is very extraordinary. I'm sorry, Theo. I don't know what you want me to do.
Pippin, it's the first time he's come to you for help.
Could you look at him?
Please, please, Pippin.
Theo, I don't know anything about ducks.
Pippin, try.
Okay. Let me have a look at him.
Now say something hopeful.
This is a very sick duck, Theo. I'm sorry, I don't think there's really much I can do to help him. Theo, wait a minute. There is something. Come here, kneel down right here next to me.
It was like a painting, man and boy in prayer.
God, I know this is going to sound ridiculous, but...
No.
This boy loves his duck.
His breath has ebbed. His pulse is low. His feet are webbed, but even so, you must know that although our tears are poised to burst, we've kept our faith warm through the worst. We haven't cursed our luck or run amok. To prayers we've stuck. Please reward our pluck and save this dog.
And you can turn, okay? One, two, three!